This is from page 6 in The Dark Fantastic by Ebony Elizabeth Thomas. When youth grow up without seeing diverse images in the mirrors, windows, and doors of children's and young adult literature, they are confined to single stories about the world around them, and ultimately the development of their imaginations is affected.
I'm going to read a quote from page 25. Once upon a time, I believed that people of color were incidental to the English language fantasy tradition. I believe that for the most part, the speculative genres did not deal directly with race, which was why I liked them. In digital fandom, I could shed my skin and just be. But when you begin to read the fantastic as a writer and a critic, you begin to notice the presence of dark shadows everywhere. Therefore, in contrast to readings of young adult literature, media, and culture that position human and non-human characters of color as marginal, I wish to position all undarkened characters and characterizations as central to both the fantastic and the construction of imagined whiteness.
And I will read from page 17 in The Dark Fantastic. Books and movies about children and teens who looked like me were read and viewed out of duty in order to learn something about the past. Books and movies that showcased the pleasures of dreaming, imagination, and escape were stories about people who did not look like me.
What happens when neither characters nor narrators in the fantastic seem to imagine you as a possible interlocutor? Although it is generally assumed that audiences are positioned to identify with the heroes and heroines in stories about stories, I began to wonder how the fantastic shapes the collective consciousness toward perceptions of difference. When might young readers experience moments of dissonance? Specifically, when might young readers of color realize that the characters I am rooting for are not positioned like me in the real world, and the characters that are positioned like me are not the team to root for? How do these readers respond to this absence? Do they assume an assimilationist stance? People are people. I can relate to any character. Do they assume a stance of resistance? This story contains no one like me, therefore it is not for me.
And I will read from page 29 in The Dark Fantastic. In contemporary culture, the project of emancipating the dark fantastic may be even more challenging than the myth-making project J.R.R. Tolkien assigned for himself. Liberating the fantastic from its fear and loathing of darkness and dark others not only requires a new narrative for the sake of undarkened readers, it requires emancipating the imagination itself.
I love that so much. Thank you, Aimee.